So Tony Benn said, I think a week ago, that all political careers end in failure. But I don't think so. I think...
It wasn't Tony. He was quoting somebody else.
No, somebody else. There you go. I saw Tony quoting somebody else. But anyway, I don't think
Enoch
so.
Enoch Powell.
Because... Because I think all these generations of struggles before us have won us rights, you know, that other generations take for granted. So the struggle for the 8-hour day, the struggle even to build organizations like the Labour Party or the Communist Party, like all these groups, no matter how big or small they were, all actually won rights for working class people. So I want to salute those organizations that we see. We are part of that heritage on the left in New Zealand, from the Wobblies, the Red Feds, the Communist Party in New Zealand. The early founders of the Labour Party were socialists, and the Socialist Action League. I just want to recognise as well that we don't think we're the only revolutionary group that exists. We've got comrades here from Fight Back, there's other groups like the ISO, and we have by and large fraternal relations in New Zealand, which I think is a much healthier a way to be than in some other countries where it's quite nasty and people score points off each other and blah, blah, blah. And I think there's two reasons for that. One is the Unite Union, where most radical leftists who are serious about the working class are involved in a project that are actually building working class power. And the second one is MANA, the Movement of the People, which we were enthusiastic builders of from the word go. And I think that's actually improved the culture to quite a lot. So I'd like to salute the other comrades from other groups who are here and welcome to the conference. Because I have to explain how we came about through a split. I don't want to go through that too much, but I used to be a member of an organization called Socialist Worker, which did really great work as well. It was it came from the Communist Party of New Zealand, fought on issues like climate change, the right to strike, student occupations, and very much the kind of work that we're still doing today. We had a falling out over what we thought the formation of a broad left party would look like, and we didn't think the Residents' Action Movement would be that vehicle. But most people now are all members of MANA, so I think that's kind of resolved itself. At that time, we did think, though, that it was important to maintain independent socialist organisation, because as we discussed during the MANA session or during the union session, the need to have an independent socialist point of view about the twists and turns of coalition governments or union deals, you know, it's important that we have a right to have an independent critique of those kind of things. So I think it is good that we did continue to build a socialist organisation. Look, when we formed originally, there was no dogma, there was no great text, there was no holy canon of leaders, no matter how much I might quote Tony Cliff at me and how much I might quote Lenin back at him. There is no gods or masters. And we did have quite an anarchic feel to us, I think, in the first couple of years that we formed, in that we were multi-tenancy. So we had people who joined us who were anarchists, who were eco-socialists, who came from different points of view, and we still do have people in our organisation who are allowed to have different points of view on whatever they disagree, you know, what the holy canon is. So some people have different ideas about Cuba, some people have different ideas, and that's okay. But we are united around the five fists, five fingers for a fist, so we'll just kind of go through that and explain how that actually relates to the work we do. So we decided first that we'd be a revolutionary socialist group, an anti-capitalist group. When people like David Cunliffe go, oh, my red roses, the roses of socialism, well, he might mean a different kind of socialism, you know. He might mean the socialism that kind of thinks occupying other people's countries is part of your international responsibility, like Tony Blair, you know, and so, well, we're not that kind of group. We believe in change from below. And struggle from below, and that's why we put a lot of our effort into building things like unions and movements and things like that. So that's the first thing, is that we believe in the change below, and actually revolution. Yeah, we use that word. I mean, we don't think it's around the corner in New Zealand, but it's certainly happening in other countries like Tunisia and Egypt, and it's a very complicated process. It isn't a magic thing, you know, it happens one day and everything's resolved and we win. Yay, the end of Star Wars, you all get the gold medals from Princess Leia. Look at what's happening with our comrades in Egypt. Real dangers, you know, twists and turns. And that's why we have to learn our history. That's why we also believe in educating people about what happened 100 years ago, this day, in this time. What impressive, facts that Owen was laying on the ground. Imagine in these streets the huge battle, the civil war that was fought between our side and the Cossacks. You know, if you've been down to McDonald's recently, you know, gonna get a similar kind of little echo there. Things haven't quite changed that much. But, you know, that's another role of a socialist group, I think, is to actually be a university for the working class where we can discover our own history. And what has gone before us. So we put a lot of energy into things like the student movement. In Auckland really, over the last few years, there's been occupations, protests, you know, and big confrontations with the police, and into the workers' movement. So some of the people here today are leaders of the McStrike campaign. So see MJ there and Taylor before. We oppose all oppressions, but like Grant said in his talk, we do believe that the working class, it's not just another spectrum in the rainbow of oppressions. It's actually the working class that unites all our struggles, right? If we're Maori, Pakeha, Tau Iwi, if we're an Indian migrant worker, if we're gay, lesbian, or transgendered, if we're Jewish, you know, all these things, what do we have in common? Most of us have to sell our labour to exist. And that's why we're involved in movements like Occupy. We helped initiate the Occupy movement here in Auckland because we do believe that the 99% should rule and that the rule of the 1% should end, that their austerity should end. And if you look at the modern working class, it is, getting more and more female, more and more brown, lots more migrant workers. And I do believe that more socialist groups internationally should try and experiment in actually trying to organise physically, not talk about it, actually organise physically the new working class where they work, in the service industries, in the McDonald's, in the private sector. This is what we need to do. So we're quite proud to be part of the Unite Union, which I think, you know, is a good example that this work can be done internationally as well. And Mike mentioned that a part of the socialist group, even if you're small, I think you can punch way above your weight, like the Socialist Action League did in the Vietnam War struggle, in the women's liberation struggle, in the Bastion Point and struggle for Tiranga Tiratanga. Well, similarly, you know, we're quite small, we're modest, we know that, and we don't make any claims to be the vanguard, but we have done some good work in the last few years. I think one of the you know, comrades could be proud of initiating the Aotearoa Not For Sale campaign and trying to get thousands of people out onto the streets. Because it's not true that people in New Zealand won't take to the streets. In fact, whenever we have called a protest, put posters up, put a bit of effort, built a united front, thousands of people have come out. The GCSB rallies, the march of trade unions to support the war fees, 6,000 strong. You know, this shows that there is a desire by people to fight. So I think that is part of a good political method, I think, is to work in united fronts with people that you disagree with, to the right of you, which is good. That's what a united front is. But maintain your independence, maintain your socialist ideas, which people, you know, do find, you know, attractive. So I think if you are looking for an organisation that wants to fight back, well, you've obviously come to the right conference because there's another conference happening down in Christchurch. Probably got more people at it, to tell you the truth. But I think 3-4 years, if those people form a government, that the people in this room